So it's important for us to discuss and define what gain, pain, and sustain means, and those three words. And so it becomes in rendition and repetition for you, just flows out of your mouth and you understand it. So the practice of doing work on the bike, I want you to be able to increase your knowledge, to gain awareness of classification of that kind of work, okay? What you've heard before and leading into us assessing energy system training and then putting it into practice on the bike, it's important to know that all of these systems are not demarcated, which means that there isn't what sometimes literature and teaching systems will tell you is that time alone will dictate the energy system. Remember, as I said previously, intent, person, and modality dictates the work. And inside of the work that's being done, they all work together, okay? But they all work at different intensities at different times. Hence, the classification then means when we say OPEX gain, it means that that's the major group that's working at that time. When we say pain, that's the major group that's working at that time. When we say sustain, that's the major group that's working to do the work at that time. How we come up with, because it's incorrect to say how we come up with, it just exists. But as work has been studied for a really long period of time, we start to recognize that there's a tie-in of what we've been given and what we're capable of that dictates these areas along the curve for energy system training. And I won't go too deep into it, I'll just touch on it a tiny bit, but I want you to think about that. In the context of no leg presses or assault bikes, in the context of no cars or machines, right? Think about that. What is that human capable of expressing in work? Maybe all that we know about for our expression of work is only because we see things existing in how we operate through that work. Whew, that was deep. But you need to go there to think about, we have been given this opportunity to do work, and you need to know what's inside of us for that expression, and it is primally tuned, right? We, for example, if an individual ran all out, guns a-blazing for 90 seconds, 5,000 years ago, they would probably feel the exact same thing as someone does today. 3,000 years ago, it still took 9 months to have a child. It still does today. See that? You have to tie in biological truths to what we can express in work. So this is largely based upon just what we're built with, okay? And then you can layer that with the experience to then say what you're actually doing. And I'll describe it in detail so you kind of know, am I doing this or am I doing that, okay? Time and the kind of work that you do in power dictates where you are on that curve. Gain is in regards to you expressing stored energy. When you do and perform OPEX gain, what we mean by that for energy system training is that you're really intentionally just trying to release and get rid of all stored energy, which you could see is quite powerful. The way we're set up as humans, we have all this stored energy inside of us ready for a survival or a freeze or a flight or a, what's the freeze, flight, fight moment. Right, we're prepared at any moment in time to do that. And look how much power we have to work with, right? This is power as scored. A massive amount of power we do have as humans when we start work. Now, if we do that work right away, and we do a lot of it with great intensity, you could see that as time goes by, what happens to that power we can express? It starts to drop. Why? Because it's only stored energy that allows us to work for a very short period of time. Okay? That's called OPEX gain. Your experience in this and your ability to be able to sustain over a long period of time allows you to express this power and then to move it out to the right. You'll hear me say that. Move it to the right. Moving it to the right means that you want to start taking that work that you've just started doing for 10 seconds and 20 seconds, 30 seconds. You want to move it as far out to the right as possible. This is now entering into what we call OPEX pain. It's not only painful because it hurts, it's painful because of the strategy that's involved in moving work to the right. Because just look at these really two simple lines, right? You can see that although it drops very quickly, it's a straight drop into something that's new in energy. And look at sustain. It's a straight curve in which there's not a lot of variability in the pacing of the work. But look at the variation between 20 seconds and 2 minutes. A massive variation in power, right? Massive. So that's why it's also called pain. It's the hardest one for us to really try to figure out how to do most effectively. The last final answer to, without getting into prescription, the way you make pain really effective is you become as aerobic as possible and as strong as you can. Little principle you could take and go to the bank with. So OPEX pain is essentially now you're trying to extend work out to the right that is essentially unsustainable. It's unsustainable. Do you see that? It doesn't go from here and then to the right. See that? It drops down in total power, and you're essentially trying to move that pace as far as you can out to the right to get three things. We're trying to take gain and just express all of our energy. That's the goal, right? Just to get rid of all of it. Just think about that. Do gain, get rid of all of it. When you do pain, you're trying to push it out and push it out and push it out and push it out so you can get a metabolic event, a stress adaptation, and you can help boost the aerobic system. That's the three main reasons why we're going to do pain. But you can see it's essentially unsustainable. Inside of that word, I guess you could call it the brother or sister, depending upon how they get along. To pain is sustain. What is unsustainable, there's also an opportunity for sustainable. It should be obvious to you that sustain also has the lowest power. Therefore, if the lowest power is being put into the work, that means it could probably extend really far out and long. So all of your notions of endurance, stamina, capacity, aerobic, etc., that's what sustain means. OPEX sustain means sustainable activity that can be made to work for really long periods of times at not too much of a change in rate. So what I mean by that, just look at this point here, right? And assume this is like 12 minutes, okay? This is 12 minutes on the time. This could be 4 hours right here. See the differential between power? It's minimal. It's minimal, right? But look at the time frame here. Remember this? This is like, what did I say, 20 seconds and 2 minutes? We're talking like a minute and 40 seconds. And look at the difference in power output, right? So this is why we say that OPEX sustain is largely skill-based. If you develop the skill, rewarding the pacer, rewarding the person that's the most patient, you can largely see that that's the growth in what you're going to get in being as sustainable as possible. Putting the volume in, learning how to pace, learning how to be sustainable as possible. So by knowing gain, pain, sustain, having them rhyme allows you to remember them very easily. You now know how to express each one of them. You now know that they're not clearly demarcated by a specific period of time. But if you know how to speak to them through language and understand them, then you'll be able to prescribe it most effectively as we get into assessing each of them and then putting them into practice with the assault bike.